Geoff, you've been on three tours down under, so you know what it's like to go and tour Australia. What's so special about an Ashes tour down under?
Just the history. The history of Australia versus England. You know, it's always been the series, and I think from an England point of view and an Australian point of view, it always will be. So it's always special, always hard fought, no inch given, and normally the best side wins.
Now, the 1978-79 series, obviously you played 14 tests up to then, so you must have felt quite settled in the side, and obviously it was a good series for yourself, 23 wickets.
Not particularly settled, you know. Even at that stage, yes, I played a fair amount of test cricket, but I was only kind of selected when the wicket was conducive for me to play. You know, it wasn't as though I was an automatic choice because I was the spinner. That wasn't the case at all. Derek Underwood had finished playing by that stage, and in that series, John Embry and Phil Edmonds came out. So there was always a question who was going to be playing, were we going to play two spinners or just one spinner or whatever. So it was never an underwritten thing. But I'd got the confidence to know that I was bowling something like decent when I went out there.
And I suppose in that respect, having played, you know, all the games in that series and taken 23 wickets, so you must have been really pleased with how it went.
Yeah, very pleased. But I remember the build-up game in Adelaide. Max O'Connell was the umpire, and I bowled two or three deliveries, and I appealed for LBW, and he just said, not out, I can't see, because I had a slanting run to the wicket, and I wasn't getting off the wicket quick enough, so actually on the impact onto the pad, he could not see, so he said, I can't see. He says, and what's more, he says, I'll be umpiring some test matches this year. He said, so if that's still the case, I'll still be able to give the not out. So I changed my run-up. Well, I had to do something about it, and I went straight on the run-up and created inadvertently a drift, and so I became much more dangerous because I was beating the bat on both sides, which was, you know, they had a kind of a reputation not playing off spinners too well, and it worked pretty well for me. I ended up, yes, getting 23 wickets and bowling as well as I'd ever bowled.
A 5-1 series victory for England almost seems unheard of these days.
It was a 5-1 victory. The games didn't go 5-1, to be fair. They were much closer than 5-1 sounds. Mike Brearley was a fantastic captain. Had worked out opposition, had worked out strength of his own side, management and psychology, everything that he put into it, it worked. And it was during the Packer series, so they were devoid of some of their best players, but so were we as well. Hence, that's probably why I was playing. But we performed under pressure at the right times, and that consequently won us the games.
And was the 5-44 at Sydney the highlight for you?
Yes, that's my best bowling that's in international cricket, so yes, obviously it was a highlight. What was nice from my point of view is that I think I batted 7 as well, and Both was 6, I was 7, so it created that kind of a depth in all-roundership, and that worked as well, so it gave us a bit of depth in the batting. But bowling-wise, I suppose throughout the series I was a threat.
And then looking back to the 82-83 series, I suppose a different looking Australia by then.
Yes, it was. Greg Chappell was back in the swing, and one or two of the others as well. They were back in it. So, but we were a different side as well. But we played good cricket, but they outplayed us. And we went into the last Test match at Sydney, 2-1 down. Looked at the wicket, thought it was going to be conducive for spinners, and Eddie Hemmings played and I played, and I think Kim Hughes and Alan Border played exceptionally well and took the game away from us. You know, there was only one result left for us in the end, that was going to be playing for a draw, which didn't do us any good. We still lost the series 2-1, but at least we fought back from 2-0 down with 2 to play and got some pride back.
Happy memories of trips down under?
Oh, fantastic. You know, it's a wonderful place to tour. The humour is very similar to ours. You know, there's no inch given, as I said earlier on. It's a real drive to be successful there, and I see no reason from a personal point of view why we can't be successful again. You know, we've turned the corner. We're a motivated side now, a quality side now, and we've performed well for the last 2 years. There's no reason why we can't continue that.